Next.
Now I'd like to call Alok Kumar from Larsen & Toubro. Is he here, Mr. Alok Kumar? Moving on forward, Ms. Rishi Gasharan. Nagarjun Y. Nagarjun, are you here?
Very good morning, everybody. I'm going to give my presentation on the pump hydro storage technology as energy storage and grid management element in the state of Karnataka for renewable energy integration. This will be the overview of my presentation, where there is a new need has been come for the pump storage schemes and the renewable energy scenario in the state of Karnataka, and the proposed Sharavati pump storage scheme, how that is going to help in terms of energy storage and grid management element. So coming to the need of pump storage scheme, the main motivation behind this is due to the ambitious plan of Government of India, where it is having a target of installing 175 gigawatt by 2022, comprising of 100 gigawatt of solar and 60 gigawatt of wind. Of this, the main reason is the increasing imbalance. As you can see, in previous days during 1960s or 70s, the need for pump storage scheme was mainly due to balance the grid, where there was imbalance between the hydel and thermal mix. But in recent trends, when you observe, there is a increasing imbalance between thermal and mainly renewable. Renewable means coming mainly it is solar and wind. So the reason is, during a day, wind generation does not take place during peak hours, and also solar generation partly take place during off-peak or partly during peak hours. So these strong natural fluctuations of both and wind and solar are bringing the need for developing energy storage schemes. And this is one of the example you can observe, where in the past year, the purple line where you can see that is the trend of the wind, and the green one is the solar. Combined these two trends, there is approximately of 5,000 megawatt of generation in the state. So whereas the state demand itself is around 10,000 megawatt. So almost the 50% of the energy is coming from combining the solar and wind. So these, and you can also see that the when you see the peak trends of the state and whereas the generation trends of the solar and wind, there is a huge gap where during the peak hours these renewables are not available, and there is a big challenge in order to achieve this peak. And mainly the wind and solar is causing the very problematic situations for mainly the base load plants, especially thermal plants, where in this case most of the thermal plants are shut down for months together in order to motivate the renewable energy. So these things are bringing the need for developing of energy storage schemes. And this is another trend in the last month, where the wind potential is less, whereas the solar has increased to around, only the solar is bringing the around 4,000 megawatt. In the previous case, it was the combination of wind and solar, it was 5,000 megawatt, whereas in this, during summer, the solar alone, it's around 4,000 megawatt. And the peak has also been raised to around 12,000 megawatt. Compared to previous some 2-3 years data, every year there is a demand of around 700-800 megawatt increase in the peak demand. So these 700 megawatt peak demand cannot be met alone by these renewables, and this is the main motivation behind thinking of the developing energy storage scheme. So there was survey carried on, and you can see the black dots where you can see those are the potential identified sites in India for developing a pump storage schemes. Whereas the highlighted the round mark, you can see those states, mainly Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Gujarat and Rajasthan, these states are contributing in the present situation. These states alone are contributing around 80% of the renewable energy because of their wind potential, including solar. And as you can see, the pump storage was developed it is not a new idea. It was developed during some 1970s and all. So around 11 sites were there. Out of that, around 5 sites are operating right now. But due to this ambitious program of solar and wind and renewable energy, though there are almost 63 sites have been identified all over India, which includes almost a capacity of 96,000 megawatt, of which around 6 sites are already being under construction, especially mainly Sardar Sarovar project of 1,200 megawatt pump storage scheme and Tere Idol project of 1,000 megawatt. And coming to Karnataka scenario, you can see the total renewable energy as of November 2008 is around 12,000 megawatt of renewable capacities have been installed in the state, of which solar is around 5,000 megawatt and wind is around 4,000 megawatt. So, and whereas the thermal is around 7,000 megawatt. So this imbalance you can see, the whereas the imbalance between the renewable energy as well as the thermal energy. These, in order to balance these things and in order to balance the grid during the peak hours, we are developing a Sharavati pump storage scheme. The studies were carried on, and morely the three potential sites were identified in the state, in the especially in the Western Ghats region. Out of this, the in the first stage, the Sharavati and Varahi scheme was chosen, and the Sharavati pre-feasibility already prepared, and the DPR is under progress. And also, whereas the Varahi scheme is around 700 megawatt, and the topographical survey of PFR is under preparations. So the Sharavati project is a, the beauty of this project is it is the first of its kind project in the Karnataka, and also the biggest in terms of capacity from in India. And in this project, we are not going to build any new dams. And that is the scheme of the Sharavati project, which was built during 1960s. The same existing dams have been used. There will not be construction of any new dams. And you can see there, they will be using the second, only the construction is involved preparing address tunnels and the construction of penstocks, where the upper stream dam in the Sharavati scheme, you can see there, there is on Talakalle dam and another is a Girsoppa dam. These two dams have been used for developing of this project, where the Talakalle dam is used as a upstream reservoir, whereas the Girsoppa dam is a lower stream reservoir. These two dams are the old dams which you are using for construction of this project. And this is the scheme, and these are the technical aspects of the project, where there are 8 units of 250 megawatt each. And the beauty of this thing is we have a very great head around 478 meter because of the natural of Western Ghats. And the another thing is from this project we can get daily peaking operations of around 5 to 6 hours of duration. This is the main thing which we require in the scenario of India, where the peaking is not for just for 1 or 2 hours, it is for a spread to a long around 3 to 4 hours peaking period is there. This project will be very helpful in that case. And the energy generation and the pumping energy, if you compare that one, there will be a cycle efficiency of 80%. And coming to the conclusion part, so increased renewable energy penetration and the government's ambitious programs have been bringing a need for energy storage, of which the pump storage schemes can also be thought, and there is also a huge potential for developing these schemes. And the Sharavati pump storage scheme uses existing dam, so therefore there is a minimal of civil works, so the project can be constructed in 5 years as per the study. And the investment and the big challenges comes in the part of environmental aspects, whereas the environment have already started their work of protecting the projects, so that there will be a lot of hampering in the environmental. Whereas there is a need to convince them, as there is no construction of any new dams, so there will not be any rehabilitation issues or any submergence like that. And coming to the financial aspect, the project cost is around 5,000 crores as per last year's estimates, rates and all. And the tariff is estimated to be around 5.33 per unit. So though it seems little bit higher, so compared to the peaking demand, and as the recent some studies have been going, India needs some hourly based tariff. In that case, this, even though it is around the higher side of 5 rupees compared to today's solar and all, where it is around 3-4 rupees like that, so it will be a very helpful project, and also a economical point of view, it will be a good project in developing and also balancing the grid. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Any questions?
Yes.
Yeah. Just on the cost, are you saying it's 5 rupees per kilowatt hour? Is that what you was?
Yes, sir. 5.33 per unit.
Yeah, but that doesn't that make it compared, and you yourself are saying compared to other storage, you know, for battery and so on, they're talking about it'll come down to about rupee per kilowatt hour. So how does that then? Then this no longer remains cost effective. Am I right? And right now batteries are more expensive, but
yes.
I'm saying the projections, if you talk to CA, and I think Mr. Batra has talked about that will come down to about a rupee per kilowatt hour.
So not any single energy storage scheme is going to solve all the problems. There is a need of mixture of technologies are required. And also, coming to the batteries, they cannot especially in India time, the peak hour is a very large gap, around 3 to 4 hours there is a peaking period. During that time also the schemes will be helpful, and also these economic aspects, you can say, although the project is going to take some 5 years duration, in those 5 years you don't know what there is rising in trends of prices or there will be a drop in tariffs. Those also can be taken to picture.
One more question from me is, you know,
yes,
in terms of the discharge of the water in the
your
downside,
yes sir,
and if it is used for agricultural schemes,
one thing
irrigation and other purposes, then when you pump it back,
mm-hmm,
is there any impact in terms of agricultural production? You have already talked about ecological impact and environmental impact.
So
the impact on, you know, irrigation water availability for the downstream farmers, is there any impact on that?
No, sir. Actually, this project comes in the Western Ghats. In the Western Ghats, there is no much part of agriculture. Where this, especially this project, Sharavati Valley is there, no? That is mainly for hydropower development. There is no any irrigation projects. Thank you.